Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing good. In this video, we are going to revise picture description. So, what is a picture description? A picture description is something when you are given with a picture and you need to describe it. That is called a picture description. So, how do you start describing a picture? First of all, you need to tell which place is that that you can see, which type of scene is that. If, for example, here in this picture, you can see this is a park, so you can write this is a scene of a park. Then you can describe the general description if there are some objects, some people, some things on the park or in the picture. Then you need to describe it generally, like there are many people at the park, maybe it is a Sunday or a public holiday. So that is why you can see so many people over there. That could be the general description. Or if any picture is given to you, you need to describe that. For example, you can see so many children over there, or there are so many birds or animals at the zoo. Then after that, you need to describe the things clockwise. So how do you describe the things clockwise? First of all, you need to explain the things that is the top right corner. Then you need to come downwards, and then you need to go bottom left side. Then you need to go upwards. So this is the clockwise direction. Like a clock has a numbers 1, 2, 3 to 12. You need to explain the things in the same way. After that, you need to mention the positions. For example, if you can see a person on the top right hand corner, then you need to tell that you can see the person or the thing or whatever you are describing with the position, like top right hand corner, then bottom right hand corner, then the center, then bottom left hand corner, and top right, top left hand corner. These are the positions, the names of the positions that you can use to describe the things in a picture. Then you need to use the adjective. Now, what are the adjectival phrases? A phrase is a group of words. An adjectival phrase means a phrase that can describe a noun. If you're talking about a person, a name of a boy or anything, then you need to describe the with the group of words that how that thing is like, or what type of thing is that. So the phrase that you will use to explain that noun, that would be called as adjectival phrase. For example, if you're describing a boy or a man in this picture that is wearing a waist pouch, so you can use an adjectival phrase that the man with a waist pouch. So that would be easier for you to explain. Then similarly, the girl with ponytails, so it means you are pointing at that girl who is wearing the who is having the ponytails. And not all the girls are the same, or not every object in the picture is same. So there are other girls or females or the ladies. So you can all if you want to tell about any other girl or any other female, then you can use the word like the phrase like the lady in a skirt. Just like that, the boy playing a trumpet and the boy wearing sunglasses. So this is how you can explain them. After explaining all the things, all the objects in the picture, you will come to an end. But how will you make the sentences? You need to make the sentences in present indefinite or present continuous tenses. So in the end, you make a conclusion like, I think everyone should play a part in making the park a pleasant place for all to play. Or you can give a general description that how you would end the end your discussion or end your description of the picture, what you have seen and what is the message that you want to give at the end. Then you need to say, this is all I have to say, thank you. This is how you would conclude the picture description, by describing all the things in the present tense. Then this is a picture that was given to you to describe. So in this picture, whatever you can see, you need to explain all the things one by one in the clockwise direction and in the present tense, present simple or present continuous. Next we have present indefinite tenses. Now what are the present indefinite tenses? The simple present tenses that you use for the daily life conversation, or when you talk about your daily habit, or if you want to tell that a thing happens sometimes or often it happens, that is used to show the regularity. for that purpose you use the present indefinite tense. Now, what is the structure? There are three further types for the present indefinite tense that you have done. Affirmative sentences, first of all, they are also called as simple or positive sentences, in which you talk the general things in a positive sentence. Like, you do not use any negative word like not, you do not ask any question. It is just simple sentence. So first of all, you write the subject, then you write the verb with the first form, then you write S or ES depending upon the subject, and after that you write the object. This is the structure and rule for the affirmative sentence in present indefinite. What is a subject? A subject is a thing or a person that performs an action in the sentence. And the action that is happening in a sentence, that called as verb. And the thing or the person on which the subject is performing the action, or that is receiving the verb, that is receiving the action, that is called as object in a sentence. Then there is this negative sentence, the second type, in which you write the subject at the first, then you write the helping verb do or does. You do not write S or ES in this, but you write simple do or does depending upon the subject. Do is used for the plural nouns and does is used for the singular nouns. Then you write not, and after that you write first form of verb, and at the end you write the object. Then comes the interrogative sentence, in which you ask the questions. So that is the third type in which you ask the questions. So what is the structure of this sentence is the helping verb do and does depending upon the subject. It comes at the first, then you write the subject, and after that you write first form of verb, and in the end you write the object and you put a question mark. So this is the structure for all these three types. There is some rule for making a sentence and writing the verbs. In positive form, you write S, ES or IES depending upon the subject or the verb. If there is singular subject, then you write the first form of verb with S and IES or ES. If the word starts from ends in a consonant, then you write S. If the word's in a vowel O sound, then you write ES at the end. And if the word sometimes end on the Y, like fly, you write IES in the end. You remove the Y. And if the subject is plural, like I, you, we, they, then you write the simple first form of verb. You do not add any S or ES after it. In negative sentences, does is used for the singular subjects and do is used for the plural subjects. So when you write he, she, it or any other singular subject or singular noun, you use does not. So and if you use any plural verb like I, we, you, they and any other plural subject, then you use do not for the sentence to make it negative. Then in the question form, in the interrogative sentences, you write the helping verb does or do depending upon the subject. If the subject is singular, then you use does, and if the subject is plural, you use do in the start. The structure will remain the same, and the end you put a question mark. Then there is these exercises that were given to you. You needed to translate the sentences from Urdu to English. There were some sentences that were given to you. Suraj Mashrik se nikalta hai, the sun rises in the east. Guriya gana gaati hai, the doll sings the song. Main school jata hoon, I go to school. Kisan fasal kaatte hain, the farmers harvest the crop. Ammi kapre dhoti hain, mother washes the clothes. These were the affirmative sentences. Then comes the negative sentences. Same sentences are there. You just need to make it negative by adding does not and do not. Does not with the singular things or singular subjects, and do not with the plural subjects or plural nouns. Then comes the interrogative sentences, in which you need to ask the questions by writing the helping verbs do or does in the start. Do is used for the plural nouns or plural subjects, and does is used for the singular subjects and singular nouns. And in the end of the these statements, these exercises, you need to write the question mark to make it a interrogative sentence.